Nobody is born knowing how to properly pick and strum a guitar. It has to be learned, and if it doesn't get developed properly, the chances are you're going to integrate bad habits learning it all on your own. Now, one of the worst of these bad habits is holding the forearm too low when you're picking. It creates a terrible angle for playing notes or chord strumming, and it also can promote a lot of tension in the hand, the wrist, and also down through the arm, even in the elbow and up into the bicep as well. If this is being done by you, then I want you to stop doing this. Seriously, when it comes to developing picking, there are three areas that need to be addressed, and I'm going to discuss them all for you in this video. As a matter of fact, I'm going to break each one of these areas down for you in detail so that you have better results without the risk of any bad habits affecting your playing performance or, you know, most importantly, the risk of you developing an injury like tendonitis or muscle carpal tunnel syndrome that can often come when you're learning guitar with bad picking hand habits. Now, a large part of this is going to be based around playing more relaxed. And if you'd like, I have a free ebook. I'll send it to you if you go to my contact form on creativeguitarstudio.com. Just send me a message and ask for the free ebook. It's called Balancing Tension and Relaxation. Also comes with a free YouTube video, and I think it'll really help you to get better at playing with less tension, and it'll, you know, allow you to have more accuracy in what you're doing as well. So let's get started. Now, there are three areas of picking hand technique that I need you to start paying a lot more attention to if you want to develop better accuracy, better picking comfort, faster picking ability, and the ability to pick single notes, as well as strum with more feel and strum guitar with a smoother, more accurate strumming style. Now, the first topic that we're going to get into discussing has to do with the picking arm's angle over the guitar's body and how this affects the way that your guitar pick is going to get in toward the guitar string that you want to pick on. Now, I want to begin here by getting you to take a look at some photos of just a few of the world's best guitar pickers. And in each image, I want you to pay attention to four things: their angle of their elbow, their forearm position across the guitar body, as well as their wrist in relation to their forearm, and if you can tell how much level of tension is actually going on. So our first guitarist is the legendary Al Di Meola. In this image, you can see how his elbow is only bent slightly. His forearm is resting across the top back edge of the guitar's body, and his wrist angle shows for that it's allowing perfect coverage of the guitar strings at the primary picking area for the style of guitar that he's playing. Remember, you know, your pick angle and where your pick is located will probably change depending on the kind of guitar that you're performing on. And one thing is, you know, overall though, that you're going to notice that these areas are very consistent as we go through different players. But also one other thing I wanted to mention is, even though it looks like he's just shredding out some kind of line here, he's still, like, you know, the forearm and the bicep and so on, it seems very relaxed. You know, he doesn't seem like he's holding a lot of tension in his hand. There's some, but, you know, not really a lot. Now, in my next example, I want to go here into legendary guitar player Steve Morris. Now, this guy is just an absolute shredder. The guy picks so fast, it's unreal. But you look at his setup here, it looks like he's just shredding through something in this image. And, you know, you can notice here that a lot of the same trademarks that we had seen with Al Di Meola's hand and arm posture are happening again with Steve Morris. Now, you notice that slight curve of the elbow, the forearms resting on the top rear edge of the guitar's body, and the slight wrist angles there for that accurate pick placement over the strings. Now, because it looks like he's just ripping out something, to me it seems that there's some tension that's built up in the forearm, but I would imagine that after he's done shredding out this line, he's going to go right back to a more relaxed state, because he's just such an amazing player when it comes to technique. You know, there's, you know, no doubt that he's playing majority of the time in a very relaxed state of mind. Let's look at another image here, a side-by-side of image of Steve Vai and Yngwie Malmsteen. And you can tell, you know, these guys are real super pickers, obviously. In this image, you know, take a close look, though, at the similarity of each of their hand, wrist, and arm angles. It's more of the same elements that we've been noticing. You know, that Steve Vai in this image looks very relaxed. Yngwie looks like he's shredding out something up higher there, and he's, you know, maybe a little more tension. But the elbow curve curve and the way the shoulders dropped, the way the forearms over the top back edge of the guitar's body, it's all the same stuff, you know, we've been seeing with all these players. The last image I want to have to go through here is of Joe Satriani. It looks like he's in an interview in this image, and I wanted to show, you know, just to have a resting image of someone, and I found this image of Joe Satriani just sitting down with a guitar. You know, it looks like he's in between maybe playing some examples during an interview, but you notice, you know, the same factors are all present here again. Even, you know, when, you know, he's not performing anything, you can tell, you know, the way the elbows bent and the forearms coming over the top back edge of the guitar's body. His picking is going to be right in the zone that it needs to be in, that primary picking area of the guitar type that he's playing. He happens to be playing what looks like a Gibson Les Paul in this shot. So, you know, all these factors with all these players, you notice that it's always the same group of elements that take place with the, you know, right from the shoulder down, you know, across the bicep, you know, across the angle of the elbow in the forearm, how it's resting over the back edge of the guitar's body. You know, all this stuff comes together to really create, you know, the ultimate area of the guitar where you want to be and how your hand, wrist, arm, shoulder, you know, everything is coming together to give you the most, you know, the best playing, you know, angle that you could possibly have when you come into the string. So you want to make sure that you're duplicating these angles because that's going to make a big difference in your guitar playing. Now, the next area I want to get into is how guitarists hold the pick. And this is an area of picking technique that often gets lost in the shuffle. You know, we have so many details with this that oftentimes many guitar teachers even don't even discuss it or talk about it much because, you know, for the pick to operate most effectively, there is a set of parameters that you want to have going on. And you can do the same double check that we just did with the forearm and wrist and elbow that we were just working on. And you can see what other, you know, of world famous guitar players, respected guitar players are doing. And it's all going to be based around the same concepts that I'm going to show you right now. When it comes to picking and getting very detailed about how you hold the pick, how you're coming at the guitar string, you know, when you play single note lines or when you play chords, there's a lot of factors going on. And the first thing I like to talk about is holding it in general. I like to, you know, promote the idea of the thumb and the index finger, just kind of having that index finger as sort of a shelf. You put the edge of the pick on it and you get the tip of the pick going into the guitar body or onto the, towards the pick guard like that. And that's really the overall, you know, ultimate way, I think, is the best way to pick. You might see some people doing, you know, different ideas. Is there going to be the minority, though? And in so far as, you know, how the hand is being held, I tend to curl my fingers in. You'll notice a lot of players do that. Some people will keep their fingers outstretched, but they'll always be brushing. There'll always be, you know, very minimal tension of the hand and the wrist when you're doing your picking action. And really, there'll never be any anchoring. You know, you don't want to anchor because as soon as you start anchoring on the pick guard or maybe anchoring from the bridge, it starts promoting tension in the hand and the wrist, and that's bad tension. We're going to do a whole section on that. It's really important to keep that way down in your playing, and anchoring is a kind of a big no-no for that. But the most important element of all this is getting into the grip of the pick, because when you play a single note melody, you're holding the pick tighter, and that means that the grip that you have between the fingers is clamping down on that guitar pick much more than as if, let's say, you're playing a rhythm guitar part. As you play rhythm strumming, that pick is far looser between your fingers, and that's what's giving you, you know, the flexibility of the pick over the guitar strings. You know, it's looser. And when you go to play, let's say, a scale, the pick tightens up again, you have a better grip, and that's how you're going to really control your dynamics of this instrument. So keep all that in mind, it's really important. Another thing I want to mention too is angle of attack for the pick, because if your pick is real straight perpendicular into the guitar like that, you're going to be creating a lot of resistance. And remember, we do want to prefer having a medium or heavy gauge of guitar pick. Too perpendicular of a pick attack is going to really create tons of resistance. So what you want to do instead is is, you know, curl your thumb down toward the floor a little bit and let that pick slip over the guitar string. It's going to create far less friction. You'll have better picking, better speed, more accuracy. So just kind of curl your thumbnail to the floor a little bit and have the edge of that guitar pick slipping over the string. Even if you try that, you're going to start noticing right away. It's going to give you way cleaner picking, and that angle is going to make a big difference if you can focus in on it and have the edge of the pick striking the strings from its side and not, you know, directly perpendicular. So keep all these elements in mind. You're going to have way better picking if you start integrating these ideas. And don't forget, it affects both single note line ideas as well as rhythm guitar strumming as well. Now, as you could imagine, getting all this down is going to take a great deal of time to perfect, but the key to success is awareness. If you want accurate, smooth picking and strumming, you're going to need to focus on the grip of your pick along with the angle of the pick into the guitar string to make all of this happen. Now, the final area I want to discuss is tension, and keeping tension low in your body as a musician of any level of playing ability is critical to having good playing success. But what I've noticed over the years is that for musicians, tension really likes to creep into the muscles of the hands, wrist, and arm, and you have to learn how to control it, because as you play, especially playing live, you have a lot of adrenaline coming through your body and you have to learn how to stay relaxed. And what's even more interesting is where tension starts. It really does start just right from the mind, and the brain is activating all this. The body creates the tension through the central nervous system, of course. You know, when we're stressed, we get a lot of chemicals in the form of adrenaline and cortisol running through us, and it all starts revving up our blood and in turn tightening our muscles, causing stress on them. Now, this may be fine if we're in a fight or flight situation, like an emergency or something like that, but playing a scale, you know, as perfectly and as quickly as possible isn't exactly a life-threatening emergency, so you want to learn how to control everything that's happening with tension in your body, and you have to keep that tension down, and as we do that, we have to focus on being relaxed while we're playing guitar at all times for the very best performance. So when it comes down to staying relaxed while playing, your best bet is to focus on the music's dynamics and on the timing. And this means you'll want to learn to pay attention to how you breathe with the flow of the rhythm parts that are being played, pay attention to the bass and drums and rhythm guitarists, and understand the music's ebb and flow. That's really going to help you stay relaxed. The biggest cause of tension is when you just start to listen to yourself too much. You know, you start to just think of the sound of your own guitar and then, you know, your own musical ideas and what you want to hear come out of the instrument and all that. And you ignore the feel of the music's flow generated by everyone else in the band, or if you're playing to a jam track, or even if you just recorded a loop on a looper pedal. Pay attention to the music in the background more. It's going to make a huge difference to how it's going to start relaxing you. It'll kind of get you out of the zone of being so worried about how you're flowing around the neck and what scales you're playing. And let that stuff try to go a little more on autopilot, and it's going to relax you much more. You know, trust in yourself, trust in your abilities, that kind of thing. Not only will you play better if you do this, but you'll play music that's more balanced sounding, because you'll be better able to tap into what you want to have occur and come from your instrument when you're, you know, relaxed and listening to the beat structure more of what's happening. And you will find yourself becoming more in tune with the actual music you're playing over. And if you focus, you know, on yourself at some point and you get too wrapped up in what you're doing exactly, just again, try to back off and go with the flow of the music more. You're going to find that's going to keep you much more relaxed as you play. Well, hey guys, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and thumbs up below. And if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. And remember, you don't want to miss any of my guitar lesson videos, so turn on those notifications and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, we'll be back here again real soon. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.
When it comes to online guitar lessons, there's no place better than creativeguitarstudio.com. General membership to the site is always free, and paid memberships to access our step-by-step beginner, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs are offered in reasonable monthly and annual packages. Skype lessons are also available if you need more specific instruction one-on-one to discuss the finer details of your guitar playing. Sign up today at creativeguitarstudio.com.
I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.